Now it's working.
Okay. I'm here to introduce some microscopies in our facility. First, we have TEM, which is JM1011. It was made by JOL, which is used electro beam to examine the specimen and get digital camera. You can save your image in your computer after you get this image. First, we need to think why we need to use TEM, because they have a lot of advantages. Two most important advantages of them is the resolution and magnification. As we know, the resolution is related to the wavelength of the light source. You can see that D is related to the lambda here. If the wavelength is short, then we can get high resolution. Otherwise, we only get low resolution. So electro beam wavelength is very short than regular visible light. It is about 100 some times shorter. So electron microscopy can get high resolution. Another advantage is the magnification. Electron microscopy, for example, TEM can get up to 1 million times magnification, while the regular light microscopy can only get up to 2,000 times magnification. Of course, electron microscopy also has its disadvantage. For example, electron microscopy is very expensive to build and to maintain. And we need to use high vacuum to, for electron microscopy, you need to use a very high vacuum because it need to use high vacuum to eliminate a scattered electron. Also, electron microscopy need a cooling system to cool the lens and pumps. Because electron microscopy has high resolution, so it needs to mount on a very stable place, such that it can eliminate vibration, and also it needs to eliminate magnetic field. Some people like to use high voltage, and some people say high voltage is not good. Some people like high voltage because, as we know, if the voltage from this equation, you see, if the voltage is high, then the resolution increases. Otherwise, if the voltage is lower, the resolution is not very high. Also, for materialist science research, they prefer to use high voltage because use high voltage, they can see thick sample. Especially for solid material research, if they want to see electrical deflection, then they have to use high voltage. But high voltage also causes damage to, especially the damaged biological sample, because the high energy electrode can cause high temperature in a small area, and then this will burn the sample. Even if you use the low magnification, this TEM may still have some problem with your sample, biological sample. There are many manufacturers for microscopy. There are three typical manufacturers, Architech, Philips, and JOL. They both make high voltage and low voltage microscopy TEM. For example, Philips has CM10, CM20, and CM30. They represent for 100 kilovolt and 200 kV and 300 kV. JEL has JM1000 series and JM2000 series and JM3000 series and replaced for 100 kV, 200 kV, and 300 kV. JOL also made 400 kV and 1000 kV many years ago. The TEM can have regular TEM, we call it TM, and also it can have skin TM. Recently, they also made cryo TM. The filament of the TM is very important part. Currently, we regularly have three kinds of filament. One is field emission. Other is LAB6. Also, we have tungsten filament. Tungsten filament is is comparably cheaper and very easy to maintain. Usually, for regular biology research, we prefer to use tungsten filament. But if you want to see high resolution, especially want to see the atoms in your material, then you have to use LAB6 or field emission. Because for high resolution microscopy, we only use polarized beam in the center of the electron beam. In this case, the aperture will be very small and the magnification will be very high. So LAB6 or field emission is unnecessary because they are very brighter than tungsten. Also, field emission has another advantage because it can make very polarized beam. So if you want to see the atoms in your material, this is basically for material science research. If you want to see the atom and the structure of atom, then field emission is the best. Also, LAB6 also available. For TEM sample preparing, it is a little bit complex, but this depends on what kind of material you have. For material science sample, if your sample is solid material, then you need to embed your sample, then polish your sample to about 10 microns. Then you stick the grease on your sample. The grease can be different. It has different types. If you see the picture there, these are all grades. The size of grades also different. They have 3 millimeter and 2.3 millimeter. So if you want to purchase grades, you need to ask what kind of grades your TEM use. It is 3 millimeter grades or 2.3 millimeter grades. After you put your grades on the sample, you need to cut a sample and put it into iron mirror to get a thin area. Usually the iron mirror is used argon. And if you use polyform material, then it is a little bit simple. You just need to put your polyform material on the fumed grades. For biology sample, the process is a little bit complex because, as we know, the electron microscopy is working in high vacuum, so the sample should be dry. So through this process, we can get a dry sample. And this process including primary fixation, post fixation, block staining, dehydration, infiltration, polymerization, trim, section, grades, and staining. Usually the grades are the same as the material science sample. The TEM in Vet School is a high contrast and brightness TEM. It has very good resolution. Also, it has a high resolution camera, which allows you to get image into copy the image into their own computer. This microscopy can be used in biological and biomedical science research, and it has very good resolution. Can go up to 0.2 nanometer, and the magnification can go up to 600,000 times. Here are two pictures of our macrophage made by, taught by our TEM. This TEM also can be used in material science research, especially for nanotechnology research. compare two images of carbon nanotube, and we can see it's not large enough for this picture. The first picture, you can see the tube, inner tube and outside tube. And for the second picture, you can see small particles attached on the surface of the nanotube. We also have SEM, which is FEI quantum 200. The SEM is basically used electron beam to observe the surface of the your sample. Here are four images. First three is biological samples. There you can see the cells in these three images, and the last image is material science. This is the diamond particle. SEM and TEM also they both use electron beam, but they are not exactly the same. For TEM, the first picture is TEM. The light goes through your specimen here, and you get image here on the screen. But for SEM, you have a detector here over your sample, so you can this detector collect secondary electrons. So TEM, you see the structure of your sample, but for SEM, you see the surface of the sample. SEM also need a dried sample because it also works in hard vacuum. So they also, for biological sample, they need primary fixation, post-fixation, dehydration, and critical point dry spectacle. The first image is the critical point dry, which for use this equipment, you can get dried sample without damage the structure of sample. And spot code is to make your sample conductive. And for material sample, if it is conductive, then it is okay. If not conductive, spot code is still necessary. SEM in vet school is in high resolution environmental SEM. It has very good resolution and contrast. It can work in high vacuum, low vacuum, or even in environment model. So the sample can be coated, uncoated, or even wet sample. So this, basically we can do any kind of sample, even liquid sample. This SEM also has an EDS attached on it, which can analyze elements in your sample. And it can also do map and line profiles, so you can see the distribution of elements in the surface of your sample. Also, it can, beam current of this SEM can be changed. The stage can be rotated 306 degrees and or tilt to 90 degrees. And the work distance can be from 5 to 48 millimeter. The resolution of this SEM depends on the use condition, but it can the maximum of this SEM resolution can be up to 3.0 nanometer. This is our laser confocal laser scanning microscopy, which is used to get high resolution optical image in different depths. The first image is our 3D image. It is a half cell of the macrophage, and the green is the membrane. You can see the cell membrane, and the red is the bacteria. So use this microscopy, you can see the distribution of the bacteria in the macrophage. And other three picture is also the biological cell, and it also has green, double stain, green and red. You can see yellow in some part. This is the colocalization position. Why we use confocal microscopy? Because for the image gets from regular microscopy, if the your sample is not thin enough, then they are blurry. And because they, for regular microscopy, the image also contains signals from out of focus plane. This is the plane up and below your focus plane. If you see the first image and the second, first image is from regular microscopy and the second image is from confocal microscopy. If you see, compare these two pictures, you can see the difference. But for regular microscopy, if you want to get a good image, you need to get, have very thin section. The section should be, the thickness should be lower than 4 microns. But thin section also cost you lost the third dimension information. Sometimes the sample is hard for, it's very hard for get thin section. And the confocal microscopy overcome these problems and can get very good image, and it can eliminate the signals from out of focus planes. Actually, confocal microscopy is just like a CAT scanner in radiologist investigating, and it can see the inner structure of the samples. Our confocal microscopy has three lasers and has eight excitation wavelengths, which covers all green or red range. And we have 4 emission channels with adjustable wavelengths. So it means that you can get emission, 4 emission at the same time. It can perform 3-dimension microscopy, and it can be used on the exam the specimen up to 100 micrometer. It can also eliminate the out-of-focus light. It is widely used. This this confocal can be used in monitoring intercellular iron concentration, and also can examine the living cell. Also, it can be used in exam interactions between proteins and protein diffusion, like we can do FITC, flat, and it is very good for colocalization analysis. Another instrument we have is called laser capture microdissection. It is used to isolate special areas from a microscopic region of tissue, cell, and organisms. Here are 3 pictures of briefly introduce how this microscopy can get. The first picture shows that we are interested in this area. And then if we use microdissection, we can only get this area, the tissues in this area without any contamination with around the surface, around area. And this microscopy is a non-contact laser-based manipulation and microdissection technique, and it can get your interest area without any contamination with other around the tissues. There is also has no contaminations between laser and your sample. It is ideal for high sensitive downstream analysis. It can isolate late living cell and isolate high quality RNA. And this, our microscopy center is a cost center, but we only charge fees for supplies. So supplies, so the cost is very, very cheaper. Also, we have problems with regular microscope and a workstation for image analyze. And I think this is the lowest price as I know in USA. Okay. Any question?
Any questions at Monroe for Dr. Wu?
No, we're good. Thank you.
Okay. How about Louisiana Tech? You guys have any questions?
We're good.
Okay. Do you have any questions?
They're of a, yeah, I do, but I probably need to talk to them off the grid because they're like, you know, they have to do with accounting and things like that.
Yeah, that's good. Okay. Well, thank you very much. And appreciate you guys participating from Louisiana Tech and from Monroe. And again, these sessions have been recorded and will be available soon, hopefully sometime next week, on the LBRN website. If you have any questions about these, or if you want to contact Matt or Dr. Wu, then you can send me an email, and I'll be happy to get you in touch with either one or both of them and help facilitate, you know, your needs in microscopy. Thanks again.